What's going on, everyone? It's Aseel Swade. Welcome to the video. In this video, I'm going to be taking you through everything I eat in a day. I'll be showing you high protein meals to lose fat. So one of the most asked questions I get is how to eat high protein. Eating high protein is easy. You just have to know what foods to eat and what meals to make. So look, if you enjoy this video whatsoever, you find it helpful or entertaining, give the video a like right now. Seriously, do it. If you don't, The Rock will come and shove 400 grams of protein in your mouth. So when you're focused on eating a high protein diet, I wanna show you all what kind of foods you should expect to include in your diet plan and what to look out for in the grocery store when you are eating a high protein diet. So check it out, guys. These are my favorite high protein foods here. We have all of our lean meats. You wanna focus on something like 93.7 lean ground beef, chicken breast, chicken thighs, fat-free high protein shredded cheeses, whole eggs, or in general using these for egg whites as well. Cottage cheese is another great dairy alternative for a high protein diet. Protein powder, of course, will always make things convenient in our life, so I definitely recommend this, especially the Impact Whey protein. I'll leave it linked in the description box down below. You already know what code to use to save 40% off. We got high protein alternative pasta. Now this is made out of chickpeas. You wanna make sure you're getting a high protein alternative for even carbohydrate sources like pasta, or in general, whatever you can find, just a higher protein version. All right, y'all, Chef Swade is out and about. We got all the ingredients needed for meal number one, so I'm gonna be making an omelet. So I'll be using whole eggs, vegetables inside my omelet, which is gonna consist of onions, spinach, and mushrooms. I'm also going to top it off with some fat-free cheddar cheese in order to bump up the protein and also keep the fats the same since it's fat-free. But anyways, what we're gonna do, crack 4 eggs and put a little bit of water and then whisk this baby. So a little trick here to make the perfect scramble, put a little bit of water with the whole egg and then whisk it, and bam, you got yourself some fluffy egg. All right, y'all, that's gonna be the base of our omelet. We have the eggs all whisked up. Gonna go ahead and cook it in a medium heat pan. Now, I'm also gonna chop up the vegetables, cook that in a separate pan, and then we're gonna transfer that over to the omelet. Let's hope I don't screw it up. All right, Bobby Flay, where you at? Shit. So I've truly done better, but we got meal number one, which is going to be the omelet. So the great thing about this meal is that it has 44 grams of protein with only 400 calories. Now you can also bump up the protein in this meal easily by adding egg whites if you want, but 44 grams is perfect for me right now, especially because there's no carbohydrates. This is purely just fat and protein because I'm starting off my day of eating a little bit earlier than I'd like to. And when I typically do that, I just kind of eliminate carbs for that first meal. It actually does really help, especially if you want to stay productive, because if I have carbs first thing in the morning, it just makes me a lot more lethargic. So try having a higher protein, higher fat meal. The number one mistake I see a lot of people doing when they switch to a high protein diet, like the one I'm about to show you all today, is that they completely eliminate both carbs and fats and just have a meal strictly high in protein. Look, you need to have a meal higher in carbs and protein and low in fat, or higher in fat and protein and low in carbs. All right, guys, so make sure you do not make that mistake. Whew, look at that. That's a damn good omelet, if I say so myself. I'm telling you, Bobby Flay, where are you, bro? Whoever's got a hookup to the Food Network, hook your boy up, man. I wanna do a little Beat Bobby Flay showdown. So damn good. Look at that cheese. That's gains, baby. So since this video is all about eating high protein, figured this is the perfect time to show you all my favorite budget-friendly high protein supplements that I've been using for literally years. This is a huge life changer. We have some Impact Whey protein powder. I love the cinnamon cereal flavor. Check out salted caramel, fruity cereal. There's so many good stuff when it comes to this, but it's got 18 grams of protein with 100 calories per scoop. And we also have some protein chips. This is the best snack that will save your diet. I mean, when you're just chilling, watching Netflix, like we usually do. This is the best snack to have and it doesn't ruin your goals. It's so freaking delicious. 120 calories with 14 grams of protein, which is unreal for potato chips. So I really wanna show you all this right now, specifically today, because my protein is officially launching their Memorial Day sale. So you're gonna save 50% off your entire order with the discount code ASEELVIP at checkout. That's ASEELVIP at checkout. Check out these supplements. I'll leave them linked in the description box down below. I'll even use a pinned comment on leaving my favorites page where you're gonna see all my favorite supplements that I use on a daily basis for years now. Just make sure you take advantage of this 50% off Memorial Day sale today. As soon as you watch this, go check for it. So again, I'll leave all this stuff linked in the description box down below. Enjoy and happy shopping for 50% off. Moving on to the next meal, and I wanna show you all how to make leftover chicken breast and white rice taste so much better than your average bro meal. What we're gonna do is use some zucchini, green onion, mushrooms, sweet teriyaki, sweet baby ray sauce, along with some low sodium soy sauce. That is literally all you're gonna need. So a couple of vegetables along with these sauces, and it's gonna completely transform this dish. Just follow along. Chop up the vegetables. Cook the vegetables in a medium heat pan. Put the chicken and rice in a medium heat pan. Toss in the cooked vegetables. Toss that sucker around. Throw in some sweet teriyaki sauce. Use a little bit of soy sauce. Stir it all up together and boil. Ain't it amazing how just a few ingredients can completely change a dish? I mean, we had some boring white rice and chicken breasts, and look at that. Bam! Look at how good this looks. I'm telling you, if you got a date, this is gonna win her over. But look, guys, if you have not yet checked out my cookbook, what are you doing, man? Like, all these meals I'm showing you in this video are all in my cookbook. If you don't know what to make every single day when it comes to high protein meals that's gonna allow you to gain muscle and lose body fat, then just check it out. You're gonna do yourself a favor because you're not gonna need anything else in the kitchen, I promise. Pick up the cookbook, you can pull it up and it'll show you step-by-step instructions on how to make over 100 plus high protein recipes just like this. It's literally going to be life-changing. There's been thousands of people that already got them themselves and they've been using it every single day. So don't miss out on it. I'll leave it linked first thing in the description box down below. Also, my cookbook is in fact called The Bro Cookbook because I wanted to add a little bit of humor into it. It's showing you all exactly how to make simple whole foods just like this into epic recipes. It truly will help you stay consistent forever with your diet. But anyways, guys, I'm going to enjoy this as a pre-workout meal. And then I'm gonna talk to you all about training in the gym on a high protein diet, because far too many of y'all think that a high protein diet itself is gonna make you gain muscle and get ripped. That's not the case. However, it will change your life when you're whipping up epic meals just like this. Oh, so good, but so hot. All right, guys, so I'm at the gym right now hitting a chest and arms workout. Listen up, eating high protein alone is not gonna allow you to build muscle, but I wanna show you all some of my favorite chest exercises that I've literally been doing every single week for years now. Nothing has changed, and this has tremendously helped build my chest. And a lot of y'all always ask me how I built my chest. I wanna show you all my exercises. All right, so the first sex we're doing, For the first exercise, we're hitting the flat dumbbell bench press. I personally prefer dumbbells over barbells, just long-term. Heavy barbell bench presses eventually screw up my shoulders. You might be someone who's more prone to injury, so do whatever's more realistic for your own body with your joints. Flat dumbbell bench press, you can never go wrong. Do 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps and get heavier and stronger every single week. We're moving on to more of a hypertrophy exercise because the first exercise is simply more of a strength-based exercise for our chest. So we're doing chest flies. I love doing this on the machine. Really make sure you're getting that mind-muscle connection here. You don't have to go too heavy, but I still like to do 3 sets of 10 to 12 reps, maybe even sometimes 15, but never go above 15 repetitions here. A common mistake is that people go too high reps. Just keep progressing every single damn week. All right, guys, so we're moving on to meal number 3, and I figured I'd show you all exactly how I set this up. So we got beef teriyaki tacos. We're gonna put a little bit of 93.7 lean ground beef on top of every single taco. By the way, I'm having 6 tacos for meal 3. I'm only gonna show you all 4 because this plate isn't even as big enough, but this is a great thing about eating high protein. Your diet is going to be high volume. You're constantly full. I mean, this meal isn't even like a ton of calories for how much food you're eating. Throw on top some fat-free shredded mozzarella cheese, bumped up the protein intake, not increase the fat. After that, we got some cooked cabbage in the teriyaki sauce. I'm just gonna sprinkle a little bit on top. You gotta give it a try. High protein hacks. Jordan's gonna kill me.
That is so damn good.
I know you want some.
I know you want some. Here, take a bite. No, not you.
You know what they say, a bowl of protmeal a day keeps the doctor away. Well, if your doctor was a seal suede, that's what he would say. But we're gonna make a bowl of protmeal for meal number four. That is going to wrap up the day of eating. So the great thing about protein oatmeal is that it's such a delicious way to make the same thing every day, but make it taste completely different. For example, you can use different flavors of protein powder and it can completely switch it up, but in reality, you're eating the same thing. So I'm using salted caramel today. We have a scoop of salted caramel Impact Whey protein. I'll leave this link in the description box down below. As usual, we have some cinnamon, sea salt, mix it all up. So I'm actually gonna put a banana in here as well, just to get a little bit more calories for the day. So that's a great thing as well. You can always add different kinds of fruits in your protein oatmeal every single day to switch it up. Use different fruits. Again, use different flavors of proteins as well if you really wanna have a different meal. It is such a treat. If you don't eat protein oatmeal, I have no idea what you're doing. You truly are missing out. There you have it, salted caramel protein oatmeal with a banana on top. So speak about protein oatmeal. There's been so many of you guys emailing me and DMing me about Broats. Broats is gonna be my new protein oatmeal company that I'm coming out with later this year. I cannot wait for you guys to get your hands on it. I've been working so hard at this. It's honestly the scariest project I've ever worked on in my entire life, but it is unbelievably exciting. I feel like all this time I've been doing YouTube was literally for the moment of me coming out with Broats and for you guys to get your hands on it. Just to give you all a little bit of context, this has 32 grams of protein, but a little over 80 grams of carbs and almost 600 calories. Broats is gonna have less than 300 calories a serving and over 30 grams of protein. Absolutely mind-blowing. Nothing in the market is going to taste like Broats. It's gonna have the same macronutrient profile as Broats. So I'll keep you all updated on exactly when that's gonna come out. And just in general, I want you all to build Broats with me because it's gonna be the biggest thing I've ever done in my entire life. And I need a team, AKA my family, AKA the Suede Squad, AKA you guys.
Cool.
Come on, family. Did y'all really think I was finished? I still got a couple more gems to drop on y'all when it comes to following a high protein diet. So follow along here, but check this out. The total macros and calories in everything I ate today, including all the high protein meals to lose fat that I showed you, consisted of 2,422 calories coming from 256 grams of carbs, 59 grams of fat, and 214 grams of protein. So two huge takeaway points here. Just a couple of bonus tips for all of y'all that are still sticking around. Number one, a great way to find the maximum amount of protein you should be consuming, just like I am today, in order to retain muscle mass and even gain muscle while you lose body fat, is to take your lean body weight and then multiply that by 1.2. That might be a little too much protein for most. It might be an unpopular opinion, but eating very high protein has really helped me keep me satiated and full while I'm dieting, and it's helped me maintain a ton of muscle and just look better as I get leaner. And then number two is to make sure you're on a calorie deficit while you're eating a high protein diet in order to actually lose body fat. So for me, this was a deficit. The protein is definitely an extremely optimal point for me to look my best while I drop body fat. But I really hope you all found this video helpful, entertaining. If you enjoyed it whatsoever, smash the like button right now. I do really appreciate it. And more importantly, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new. Guys, we're almost at 500,000 subscribers, which is absolutely insane, but we're not there yet. So I need your help in getting there. So hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell right next to it so you know when I upload new videos every single week. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see every single one of you in the next video.